In this illustration, let's study about the charging of a capacitive circuit. Here you can see the figure shows a circuit having some capacitors. And here if switch S1 is closed, we are required to find the charges on all these capacitors. And now if S2 is also closed, again find the charges on these capacitors. Now in this situation, if we talk about the initial state when S2 is open and the switch S1 is closed, we can distribute the potential in the circuit due to this 12 volt battery. We can take on the right hand side the reference as zero potential, then on the left hand side due to this battery, the potential is 12 volt. And at these two nodes, we can consider potential to be X and Y. Now here, if we write the equation for the potential X, that we can simply write by summing up the charges of these two plates to be zero, which we already studied. So it will be 3x plus 1 multiplied by x minus 12 is equals to 0. And if we write equation for y, here you can see y is connected with these two plates. So charge on this plate is 4y plus charge on the right side of the plate of 2 microfarad capacitors 2 multiplied by y minus 12, and this should be equal to 0. Now if you simplify these two linear equations, I am leaving the solution to you. I can directly write the result by solving these equations. You will get x is equals to 3 volt and the value of y will be 4 volt. Now in this situation, if we are having the value of x and y, you can directly get the charges on all these capacitors as charge on 1 microfarad is equals to charge on 3 microfarad capacitor, because both of these are in series as the switch S2 is open. So this charge can be written as 3x. So this will be 3 multiplied by 3, that is 9 microcoulomb. And for charge on 2 microfarad, which is equal to charge on 4 microfarad, as again both of these are also in series, the charges will be equal. And this should be 4y. This 4 multiplied by the value of y is also 4, so it is 16 microcoulomb. So this is the answer to first part of this situation, where only switch S1 is closed. Now if we also close down the switch S2, we can draw the circuit diagram again as circuit after closing S2 is, this we can redraw as I'm drawing here. You can carefully see this. This is 1 microfarad, 2 microfarad, and this switch is now closed, so the middle branch will also be introduced in the circuit. This is 4 microfarad, and here it is the 12 volt battery, and switch S1 is also taken as the closed switch. If we wish to find out the charges on these capacitors, here we can consider 1 and 2 to be in parallel, 3 and 4 to be in parallel, and the group is in series. Or you can calculate the value of charges by distribution of potential. Like here, if we take 0 potential as reference, on the left hand side it is 12 volt, and this whole node will have a common potential, say x. So if we write the equation for x, this you can write as 3x plus 4x plus this 1 multiplied by x minus 12 plus this 2 multiplied by x minus 12 is equals to 0. If we simplify this, this is 3x plus 4x 7x plus x 8x plus 2x, this will be 10x is equals to 36. So the value of x will be 3.6 volt. Now if we have the value of x, you can directly write down the charges on these capacitors. Like charge on 1 microfarad capacitor is 1 multiplied by 12 minus x. So the value you will get is 8.4 microcoulomb. Charge on 2 microfarad capacitor we can write as 2 multiplied by 12 minus x. So this twice of this, that will be 16.8 microcoulomb. We calculate the value of Q3 microfarad. Charge on 3 microfarad capacitor, the value is 3x. So that can be directly calculated by substituting the value of x. That will be 10.8 microcoulomb. Here I can write the value of 4 microfarad. Charge on 4 microfarad capacitor we can write as 4x. So this will be 4 multiplied by 3.6. The value will be given as 14.4 microcoulomb. So these are the answers to this problem.